setting parameters and arguments. So I have a simple function here called addTwoNumbers, just creates two variables, add him together, and displays the result. But it's not very useful, because it always adding the sum two numbers together, always 5 and 10, no matter how many times we call it. Now to be more flexible than that, I will like this function to be able to add different numbers together, and we can do that by defining parameters for this function. And whenever we call it, we are going to pass information into it. That's what parentheses were for, after the function name. They allow us to say, do we pass one piece of information to this, or two or a dozen? So all we need to do is, to give the name in what will become, two variables. In this case what I can do is to remove my variable declaration, var a, and var b, and just say, this function takes, two parameters called, a, comma, b, or more parameters like, c, and I can call whatever I want, whatever is meaningful, because they have the same rules as variable names. Because what's happening here is, we will have variables created for us called, a, and b. That means, the first line that we can run here is, var, result, equal a, plus b. Those parameters that we passing into this function, will be added together, and will display the result. Now, if my function expects information pass into it, we better pass information when we are calling it. So we can create two variables, and pass in the variable names, or, in this case, I just can pass in, 5, comma 10. Now we say this, and when this function is called, 5 will be passed in, under the name A, and 10 will be passed in, under the name B. We save it, and run it. And we should have the 15, alert dialog box. Now the flexibility of this, simple means that I could call it again, pass in different numbers. Save that. Run it again. And we will get three alert boxes 15, 600, and minus 2316. Now when you start working, when defining parameters to your functions, you often hear the term arguments as well. So again, when you defining a function, here you defining a, and b, they are your parameters. When you calling him, the function, you are passing in, 5, and 10, these are your arguments. Now if you think this is a little strange, bear in mind, and to get an idea, the very first thing that we did in JavaScript, was calling a function, passing in, a parameter. When I said, alert, hello world, I'm calling the built-in, alert function in JavaScript, passing in, the string literal, hello world, has an argument. But let takes this one, a little bit further. Instead to pass information, into a function, we can also pass information, out of a function. And the way we do that, is by using a new keyword, called, return. If I want to create this result, by adding this two number together, and instead by piping up an alert box, I just want to pass that result back, to whoever called this function. So all I'm going to say is, return, result. So the question is, what this will do? Now the soon you hit the word return, you will actually jump right out from this function. So you don't want to start creating new variables, after this. Because you'll never actually get to this line of code. When we call the function, we will be executing the first line, and then the second line, and when this one is executed, return result, we going to jump back to ever call this. So it is often the last line of the function. Although occasionally you can use return to leave a function, earlier, if you need to. So what happens, if we say return result, what is going to happen now? I'm just going to save, and run this page. And we'll see nothing happen at all. The function is actually being called, three times, and its returning results, is return this numbers added together, but I'm not doing anything with this returning results. What we need to do is something like this, create a new variable, and set it equal to, whatever happens, when I call addTwoNumbers function. So in this case, we going to pass in, 5, and 10, they will be added together in the function, that number will be returned, and the result will be stored in the variable called x. We could then pop up an alert box. Save this and run it. We should get one alert box saying 15. As you can see, even if a function returns values, I don't have to do anything with the information it's returned, but most of the time, you want to. And again, if this looked very unusable, this is what we are using very earlier, when we called the prompt function in JavaScript. Prompt is a built-in JavaScript function. He takes an one argument, in this case a string displayed. And then whatever returned from that is what we accepted to a variable called name. So both passing information and passing in arguments to be received as parameters in the function and returning values. It's a very core piece in any programming language and something you will be using all the time.